to the Spiritual Revival Hour. This is the founding program here on Least Access TV, now Channel 28, created by Dr. Benjamin Twin B. Brown. We represent words and songs of inspiration, consolation, meditation, and education. I am Victoria Carrion, 12 years old, the youngest co-host on our production team. And we're going to begin our presentation today with a special dedication to our senior citizens, sick, shut-ins, along with the less fortunate.
Blessings and so many open doors. Abraham knew mercy along with each new day. That's why
Welcome to another edition of your Spiritual Revival Hour. It's always a pleasure to be able to come back into your homes once again. This is the founding program here on Lisa Access Channel 28. This is the time of year as we move into November and Christmas season and all that. People think about giving and receiving. Not only giving, the people look to receive. And here on the Spiritual Revival Hour, for a number of years that we have been here, we've always been interested in supplying the community with information, how they can receive things that's for them. There are so many things that's available that people don't know. And as you know, I often say, how can we expect people to participate when they don't know what's going on? Now, a lot of you have heard about the food bank. And food bank supplies food. That's the most common way to remember the food bank. But you don't know a lot of details about how the food bank can help you. So we have with us today a special gentleman who's going to let you know all the different ways that the Food Bank of Delaware can help you. And as I said, people are thinking about Thanksgiving and how they're going to eat for Thanksgiving, for Christmas and all of that. And that's right. I'm along with you. So we have Brother Chad Robertson here with us from the Food Bank. Glad to have you here.
Happy to be here. Thank you so much.
And years ago, we worked with the food bank and advertised here on this program. We had a couple of commercials that we ran, but it wasn't into details. And with the economy like it is and people suffering and different people don't know really how to take the advantage of opportunities, we invited you to come down. And we're going to let you, in your own words, just tell us what the Delaware Food Bank is all about and how the food bank can serve the average person.
Well, certainly, thank you again for letting us be here. It's a great opportunity to share all the things that we have going on at the food bank with all the folks that watch the Spiritual Revival Hour. And you hit the nail on the head. We know that so many in our community are struggling with food insecurity, and so many are still reeling from the effects of the pandemic. It changed our lives for 2 years plus. And so that makes an incredible difference as we think about how folks are getting through that. And then today, the high cost of food in the store, things that people are experiencing in that regard, we know so many across our state need assistance. And so we wanna be here to help them, to provide food for them. And as our CEO says, it's food for today and food for tomorrow. How can we get food in somebody's belly today because they need help today? But also, how can we help them tomorrow? How can we make tomorrow a brighter day and hopefully have them in the days ahead not have to count on our services anymore because they've reached self-sufficiency?
Now, there are so many different ways people can access the food that the food bank have to offer. So we're just going to let you, in your own way, just take your time and explain to people, for the average person who know about the food bank but don't know the different services and different categories that they can supply the service.
Sure. Happy to share. So many folks know that we're located down in Newark. So we bought a new facility right before the pandemic. So in 2019, moved into a new facility, 222 Lake Drive in Newark, down in the Pencader Industrial Park, just off of 896. And so it's that facility that we use to serve across Newcastle County, including Wilmington. And so from that facility, first, a lot of folks don't know that they can access our Healthy Pantry Center, which is right there at our facility. So someone can come down, they can get food assistance right there. Now, in the beginning of the pandemic, we switched that to a contactless model. So we've maintained that to today, where folks come, they pull up in their car, our staff come out, get a little staff or volunteers, get a little bit of information from them, and then bring them out a cart. And that cart has got a variety of non-perishable food items in it. So the traditional things that you might think of, canned food items, cereals and the like, anything that's available that we have. And then also perishable items are also added to that. So our goal was to always try to provide milk, you know, eggs if they're available, proteins when they're available, fresh produce. So all of those things are things that we like to make sure that we can try to add to that cart of non-perishable food items for folks that need that assistance. Now on the perishable side, some of that is actually coming from our farm. We have a 5-acre farm at our Newark site where we're growing our own produce. And so that's something that, it's, you know, fresh produce that we know we've grown there that we can get out to folks that need it. But we certainly know that not everybody can make it down to our facility down in Newark. It's a little bit of a hike. And so we try to make sure that through our mobile pantry programs that we're out actually in the community. So we're bringing a truck out, we're throwing open the doors of the truck there, and servicing the community, you know, right close to where people are. And so I encourage folks to always be on the lookout for, you know, for where those mobile pantries are taking place in their community. But a big one that we have, so in the beginning of the pandemic, we started what we called mass food distributions. Once each county, once each month, since 2020, we've hosted those larger distributions. So we have one coming up in Stanton at the Dell Tech there in Stanton on November 18th. And that's an opportunity again for folks to come contactless model. They pull up in their car. Our team, volunteers or staff will get some information from them. And then they'll drive right through the line and all that food will be put right into their car. So again, that's an easier way for folks that have that ability to be able to come out to that distribution and get assistance there. Folks say, well, what about the days ahead? So we definitely have to look at making sure that we're providing the best service that we have. So we'll be doing those distributions in November on the 18th, and again, another round in December, and then we'll be moving to quarterly in 2023.
What about if a carload of people come down? All of them will be served?
So yes, we want to make sure that everyone needs to be present to receive assistance, and they need to have some form of letting us know that they live in Delaware. So that can be an ID or a similar, you know, card, ID card, driver's license, that type of thing, or something that has a Delaware address on it. So if they have a utility bill or something of the like, a piece of mail that they can bring and show that they live in Delaware, we do need to see that they live in Delaware as well.
But maybe one of the senior centers, they wanted the seniors to load up on the bus and bring a bus load down there. All of them would be served once they have the proper ID?
That's right, yep. So they, if they, you know, wanted to get together and make a day trip out of it and come on down, they could certainly do that. Again, we'll just want to make sure that everyone that wants to receive assistance that's on the bus or the van or whatever has their ID, that we can, you know, get them all signed in and be able to provide assistance for all of them.
Now, and before we close out this segment, do you have anything that you want somebody sitting down listening to you now to remember before we close this segment?
I think the most important thing is for folks to just remember that it's not a bad thing to need food assistance, that we are a no judgment zone. We want to make sure that we're there for people to help people that need it. It's not for us to determine how or why anyone is in the situation that they're in. We're just here to help. And so folks, I encourage folks to remember that we are here to provide the assistance that folks need. We want to be there to help them, and they should not have any issues with coming out to get the assistance that's available to them.
Ben, this has been the first portion for this program, the Spiritual Revival Hour. We're trying to inform you of how you can help yourself through the Food Bank of Delaware. We have with us Brother Chad Robinson, and we're going to return later in the program to give you some more information. Remember, this is about words and songs of inspiration, consolation, meditation, and education.
Know the Lord will make a way. Oh, yes, He will. Oh, I know the Lord will make a way. Yes, He will.
Attention everyone on Medicare. New Medicare Advantage plans are now available. Did you know that you may be eligible for additional Medicare-approved benefits that include free eyeglasses, free hearing aids, free meal delivery, free rides to medical appointments, and much more? The Medicare Benefits Hotline is now open. Just call the toll-free number on your screen now to see if you qualify for additional Medicare benefits and make sure you're getting all the benefits you deserve. Just call 800-520-3805 now. In addition to dental, vision, hearing, and prescription drug coverage, you may also qualify for $0 monthly premiums, $0 deductibles, and no copays. Just call the toll-free number on your screen now to see if you're eligible for additional Medicare benefits that may include free eyeglasses, free hearing aids, free meal delivery, free rides to medical appointments, and much more. The call and Medicare benefits review are absolutely free. There's no obligation to enroll. Just call 800-520-3805 to see if you qualify.
They come to make you strong. Floating on the sea of trouble. Sorrow falling like rain from the sky. Trotting through life's murky waters. Trials form the tears in your eyes. Don't. I'm telling you, there's a blessing on the other side of you.
Over the years, we've met so many nice people and good customers. I call them my friends. Most of my furniture is contemporary. Good style, good quality. My son does all the buying. We have the lowest prices around. We try to cater to what the area wants. We have a wonderful delivery service, probably better than anybody in the city. We've been here 34 years. Just come in and say hi.
I didn't have no money. I told. I'm Shanae Darby inviting you to consider what better way to celebrate Black History Month than to support a legend of over 50 plus years of dedicated, committed services to the community. Dr. Benjamin Twinbee Brown and Community Communications Corporations introduce internet cable to Wilmington and Newcastle County. It is also the creator of Lease Access TV programming you now enjoy here on Channel 28. It is the godfather of the annual Thanksgiving, Christmas dinner, and turkey, giveaways to the community for over 40 years, one of the founding members of the Minister's Action Councils, known as IMAC, conducted the largest successful voter education and registration drive ever in our county. For over 42 years, conducted studio and on-site hands-on video workshops for youth and adults. Created the longest airing local cable TV programming and many more broadcasting entities. He is still active and productive to this day. Oh, what a legacy. If you would like to support Dr. Benjamin Twinbee Brown and Community Communications Corporation, contact us at 302-287-4413. If your call is not answered, please leave a clear message carefully stating your name, an email address, and detailing information will be emailed to you promptly.
Just in case you just joined us in our first segment, we have with us today a representative from the Food Bank of Delaware with information on how you can be served by the Food Bank of Delaware. And there are so many different ways the Food Bank will make sure that your needs are supplied when it comes down to food. We have with us Brother Chad Robinson, and we've had wonderful conversations with him this past week. And he's here today, if you're just joining us, to make sure you understand all of the details on how you can be served with food from the Food Bank of Delaware. Brother Chad, we want to continue with informing the community just how they can be served. You have so many different ways that people can be served. Most people don't know about the food bank and they have food to serve you, but they don't know the different ways they can be served. Right. And that's why you're here today. You want to continue our conversation?
Absolutely. So we talked about, in the earlier segment, we talked about the Healthy Pantry Center down at our Newark facility where folks can come and get direct assistance. We also talked about those mass distributions and mobile pantries where we're actually in the community. But another pretty exciting way, I think, for folks to receive assistance is through our home delivery program. And so at the beginning of the pandemic, we know that we had to begin to think differently about how we were receiving assistance, all of us, right? We started to do drive up curbside at the, you know, the grocery store and even a fast food restaurant, right? We could get curbside service. And so we really thought at the food bank then about how we could also maybe offer home delivery to our friends and neighbors across the state. And so in partnership with DoorDash and Amazon, we have opportunities now for folks to receive assistance right at their home. Again, we know that so many in our community can't get out. They might be homebound for a variety of reasons. Maybe they have children and they, you know, don't want to try to load the kids up in the car and get to a distribution. Or most importantly, they might be working and they just can't make it, you know, at the time that a distribution's available to them. And so being able to have that home delivery, just like we would get an Amazon package or something delivered, you know, to the house.
Yes.
We can provide that same thing through the food bank. And so folks can log on to our website, www.fbd.org. When they get there, click the food distribution link and then home delivery. And when they do that, they'll see options there for how to go on, put that information in, schedule that delivery, and be able to get that food assistance right at their door.
Okay, now there are so many different ways people can do things. That people have different, they have remembrance of bad. Senior citizens don't quite understand how to do things like that. At your website, what will they find on the website that'll help them to remember the different ways how they can access the food?
That's a great question. I think that our website's pretty easy to navigate. If a person is looking for food assistance, they want to go to that food distribution section. They'll see information about the Healthy Pantry Center we talked about. They'll see information about the mobile pantries, that home delivery, all those options that they have to get food assistance that they need. And so that's an easy way. Think food distribution. How do I get food? They can find all that information right there. But they're also going to find information about some of our other programs as well. So the other things that we offer, that food for tomorrow. If folks need help signing up for SNAP benefits or WIC benefits or Medicaid or things like that, we have folks on staff that can help them do that. We have folks on staff that can help with Stand By Me financial coaching if folks want to think about how to save the money that they might have or put money away for something they want to do in the future. We have folks on staff that can help with that. But then we also have workforce development programs. We have a culinary school and a logic training program, that's warehousing and logistics, where we provide training for folks that want to come in, get a set of skills, and go out and enter the workforce. We're very happy with those two programs. They graduate a number of students each year that are going out, being able to make money, get a job, move into the community, make money that they can use for themselves and their families. So all of those things are programs that folks are going to find in the workforce and community development section of that website. And that's a great chance for them to get those additional services that they might need that aren't food, connected to food, but aren't exactly food in that way.
Now, you have to be a resident of Delaware, right?
Yes. Yep. We serve, our service area is the state of Delaware. So we want to make sure that folks are residents here in the state. But similarly to Delaware, if they live over the line in Maryland, maybe, or in southern Jersey or southern Pennsylvania, there are food banks in all of those places as well that can provide services for them if they need it.
And you don't have to dress up because you don't have to get out the car, right?
Oh, no, absolutely not. Absolutely not. I'm dressed up today more than I would be when I go to work. So folks just need to come as they are. We want to be there to provide the assistance that they need. And again, no judgment zone, like we said earlier. Folks just need to be able to access those services that are that they need and to get those resources that are there for them.
Our many years here on Spiritual Revival Hour, we work with so many organizations that have services that, and most times senior citizens, people get old and shut in, they really don't know the services that's in the community for them. And the food bank have so many different ways that you can serve them. And just as we close out this segment, just tell us about the ways you can think of that maybe we haven't covered already,
sure,
and how people can exercise the privilege from the food bank.
Absolutely. So I think a lot of folks, again, we associate the food bank with a need for food, and so there's that obviously piece that's vitally important. There's all of those pieces that surround food, those food for tomorrow options. But I don't want to discount too that you probably have many listeners who want to engage with the food bank and might think, I'd love to volunteer. I'd love to, if I'm able and have the ability to go out and assist. And so a lot of folks want that opportunity too, or maybe for their children or their grandchildren. So that's another thing that folks can find on our website is ways that they can get involved. The Spiritual Revival Hour has been a bulwark of folks who want to be involved in the community, who want to help their community. And so by going on, they can see volunteer opportunities that are available right there. They can sign up for those volunteer hours to help serve their own community and partnership with us. We'll bring the truck, we'll bring the resources, and they just bring themselves and their friends and family to come out and volunteer to help their community too. And I know that so many watching today,
yes,
will want to do that as well, or want to make that opportunity available to their children and grandchildren. So I think that's something that's pretty important too, is that while we're giving so much, we also need the help of so many in order to make sure that we can do the work that we do, that we can be there for the community. It truly takes a village.
Actually, you are saying nobody should have to do without food. You have food available. We just have to know how to access the food and how to take the advantage of the opportunity. So we're just happy to have you here, and we're going to invite you to come back at another time. We're going to continue our distribution and advertisement of the services that you rendered. As I said before, we worked with Food Bank before down through the years. So it's just been a pleasure to have you here to come down and let us know, and let the people in the community know how they can take the advantage of all the many opportunities and the different ways, yep, that they can access the food from you. Friends, this has been a special program, an informational program. You often hear me say down through the years, how can we expect people to participate when they don't know what's going on? This is your Spiritual Revival, our words and songs of consolation, inspiration, meditation, and education.
All right, sing this with your children. One last song, Walk With Me, and we're going to minister this.
Walk with me, Lord. Walk with me. Walk with me, Lord. Walk with me. While I'm on this Jesus journey, Lord, I want Jesus every day of my life to walk with me. Walk with me, Jesus, please. Walk with me.
Walk with me.
Walk with me, Lord. Will you walk with me?
Walk with me.
Well, while I'm on this, Jesus' journey. Oh, and I want Jesus every day of my life to walk with me. Come on, sing it.
Be my friend.
Be my friend, Lord. Will you be my friend?
Be my friend.
While I'm on this Jesus journey, I want Jesus every day of my life to be my friend. Children, come on. Walk with me.
Walk with me.
Walk with me. Yeah. I need you to walk with me. Come on, Beverly, help me. I need you to walk with me. Beverly Crawford, take it. Come on, put your hands together in the name of Lord Jesus Christ. Walk, 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 walk. If you're going through something, stand on your feet and start walking. Come on. Yea, though I walk to the valley of the shadows of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me.